discuss briefly in the planning section what we need to do. The first thing that we do is to analyze the situation, right? We define your purpose and develop a certain audience profile. So the first step that we need to do is to analyze the situation, right? After that, the next important step is to gather certain information. Obviously, there are going to be certain information needs whenever we are writing. Otherwise, we wouldn't have been writing, right? So, gathering information, the next step is to choose a certain medium or channel so that your message can be delivered. And the last one is organizing the information. Now, all these things, these are actually a part of planning, right? The next major step, step number two, is writing, right? In writing, what we need to do, the first thing which we need to do is adapt to our audiences, right? Audiences are very important, and whatever we do, whatever we write or maybe speak or anything is actually directed towards a certain audience, right? So we need to be sensitive to the audience need, and we need to be using the you attitude, which we actually discussed earlier. So adapting to the audience is very important, and then how to compose the message, how actually write the message, what words to use, what sort of sentence structure to use. These type of things are actually included in this step. The third step of the three-step writing process is completing the message. Completing the message actually, in a way you can say it, give this step actually give some final touches to the message. The first step inside the completion is revise the message. You just go through it again and again, you proofread it, you edit it, you rewrite it so that everything can be as concise and as clear as possible. Then producing the message, then proofreading the message, and ultimately the last step would be to distribute the message. Distribute message is when you just float the message, when you send it towards the intended audience, right? Now, these are the three important steps that we need to take whenever we are planning a message. Starting from the first one, writing. Sorry, I have not added the relevant heading in that slide, but we will just continue with it. The first step, we are starting with the first step, that is known as planning. Well, actually, I have added the right heading, so it's all right. We start with planning, which is the first major step of the three-step writing process. Now, before going to that, I'll just briefly discuss something. Optimizing your writing time is very important. At times, what we do that we spend a lot of time in writing, and we do not, or maybe in some cases we spend a lot of time on maybe planning and leave lesser time for your writing. So this shouldn't be this way. In an ideal setting, 50% of the time can be dedicated to planning, 25% of the time can be dedicated to writing, and 25% of the time should be dedicated to completing a message. Now, this is not a hard and fast rule, but this is how you should actually plan whenever you are writing something. So, coming back to the first process, planning effectively. Now, planning is very important, right? As soon as the need to create a message appears, inexperienced communicators are often tempted to dive directly into writing. Obviously, we write whenever a certain need arises, a need of providing certain information. So, what an inexperienced writer would do that before any planning or before any even thinking about it, just in the excitement of the moment, they would just dive directly to writing. And yes, they will write something, and which must be pretty good. But the problem here is that when we skip the planning process, when we skip the thought process which is actually required to write properly, there are a lot of problems are actually created in the future. When we move along the process, issues arise, and what happens that then we need to correct them, we need to rectify them as we move on, and it takes a lot of time and a lot of effort, right? So planning effectively is very important. Now, planning starts with analyzing the situation, analyzing the context. Every communication that actually takes place, it takes place in a certain context, in a certain situation, in a certain set of circumstances, right? And those circumstances, that context or that situation, it needs to be understood, right? Because context or situation is very important, because how your audience would actually respond to your message is highly dependent on the situation, right? So again, I have noticed in this slide, the first heading, it should be analyzing the situation, not analyzing the information. It's a mistake I have made, but we will carry on. I just wanted to bring it to your notice, right? So analyzing the situation is the first step, and it is very important because we need to be aware of what is happening, and we need to be aware of what the audience must be feeling and how they would probably respond. Analyzing the situation, the first thing that we need to do is that we need to define our purpose. Now, all business communications, all business messages, they have general purposes, right? In general, they have larger purposes, like maybe to inform someone, or maybe to persuade someone, or maybe getting someone to collaborate with us, or things like that. Now, these are general purposes. Inside these general purposes, we do have very specific purposes as well. Maybe you are trying to write an email, or maybe you are trying to make an advertisement, and those advertisements or those email can be very specific purposes, right? Maybe in a certain email you are trying to get a specific person to get to the office at the proper time. Now, this is a very specific purpose. So general purposes are to inform someone, to persuade someone, to collaborate with someone, but specific purpose can be anything. There is a wide range of possibilities, right? So the first thing is that we need to be clear about our purpose. We need to define it. We need to know that what this message is actually being, the message that is being prepared, what is actually the intention behind it, what we need that message to do, right? So now purposes, the purpose also should be meaningful, right? So in order to test your purpose, whether it is a good purpose, whether it is something significant or not, there are certain questions we need to answer ourselves before we actually set the purpose of the information, right? Here it is. The first question that we need to ask ourselves is, will anything change as a result of your message? Right? Whatever message you are actually trying to send, will it make a difference or not? If it does make a difference, then it's all right, we can carry on with it. But if it does not make a difference, then I guess it won't be very wise to utilize information, utilize our energies on it. Right? Then the next question that we need to answer ourselves is that, is your purpose realistic? Whatever purpose we have in mind, whether it is possible or not, it can happen or not. Right? In most cases, we set some unrealistic purposes and then they are bound to fail, and it causes failure. So what we need to do is that we need to make our purpose realistic. Is the time right? Whenever you are communicating, is that specific time right for that sort of communication or not? And the last one is that, is your purpose acceptable to your organization or not? That is also very important. You should be clear about the fact that whatever you are communicating, whatever you are proposing, or whatever you are doing, would that be acceptable to your organization or not? Right? The next step into analyzing the situation is developing an audience profile. Now, we have discussed it many times that we should know about the audience, right? We should ask ourselves the question, and we should know the answer to these questions, that who are the people I am addressing? How many people do I want to reach? Right? How much do they already know about that specific subject? What is their probable reaction to these messages? Now, these are the sort of questions we need to know the answer of these questions before we can actually start communicating them. The first thing that we need to do is to identify our prime audience, right? Audience are very important, but inside a specific audience, there are also categories. Some audience may not be of great importance to us, but some audience may be of great importance to us, right? There must be less influential audience and more influential audience. I'll give you an example. For example, if you are trying to write something for a TV commercial or TV advertisement, and that advertisement is for Pampers, the baby diapers that are actually being used nowadays. There are many brands. We have Pampers, we have Molfex, and many other brands like these. So in this case, whenever we are trying to send a message, now kids are obviously a relevant part of that demand, but the more important part of that demand are the parents, because parents are those people who are actually going to buy them. So in this case, parents are actually the more influential audience. Again, this was just one example. In any communication, in any meeting or anything, there are some audience which are less influential and some are more influential. So we must identify them. We cannot ignore the audience which are less influential. No, we will never ignore the needs of them, but we will have a special focus on our more influential audience. The next thing is to determine the size and geographic distribution. It is very important. We should know about, because there is a difference when you aim a message to 10,000 people or maybe a dozen people in a hall, right? Determining the audience composition: what cultures do they have? What languages? What ages? What education? Organizational ranks? What statuses do they have? What attitudes? What experiences? Motivations? Beliefs? Biases? All these things. What is the composition of our audience? We need to be aware of these things as much as possible, right? So considering these things, we would be able to definitely write a good message. Then gauge the audience members of level of understanding, right? The level of understanding of the audience is also very important. Maybe the level of audience, the level of understanding of the audience is not very higher, it is on the lower side, but the speaker is actually speaking about something which may be too far complicated for them. They may not be aware of them. So in this case, we would not be able to write a good message. A very simple example, a very common example I give you. If you just go and look at a book of little children, maybe class 1 and 2. Now, these books, when you read stories in them, those stories are very simple. Very simple words, they have very simple ideas in those stories, right? So, that is because the level of understanding of those audience is not that much developed, right? So, we should be aware of the level of audience, right? If the level of audience is higher, then we must also communicate on a higher level. Understanding the audience expectations and preferences, it is very important. What is the audience expecting from you? What are their preferences? What do they like? What do they not like? All these things need to be considered. And the last thing is forecasting the probable audience reaction. It is also very important. You should be mentally aware. You should be mentally prepared for possible responses of the audience, right? And in response to that reaction of the audience, you should be ready and you should be prepared to face that, right? So this was about analyzing the situation. The next thing that we have is gathering information. Information is very important in any sort of communication, because information is the information actually gives you the basis on what you are writing a message or trying to communicate, right? So gathering information is very important. There are many sources of information whenever we are collecting information, we need to do a few things. The first thing is consider the audience's perspective. Put yourselves in the audience's shoes. Try to think like them. Create empathy, right? Put yourself in the audience's position. What are these people thinking? What are they feeling? What are they planning? What information do they need to move forward, right? What is important for them? So you should be aware of these type of things, right, while gathering information. The next thing is listen to the community. Listening to the community, people around you, the stakeholders around you, they are a very good source of information, right? For almost any subject related to business these days, there are great chances that there is a community of customers, right? Product enthusiasts. You must have seen on Facebook, there are a lot of communities related to different products, right? Maybe some medical product, or maybe some shoes that you buy online, or maybe handbags, or maybe laptops or mobile phones or anything. All of these things, they have built online communities nowadays, right? And people discuss issues with the products, people discuss what they want, people comment on things, people share their experiences, and they are very influential. These communities are very influential in creating a public opinion, right? So you should listen to these communities, you should get the information from there as well. Read reports and other company documents. We have different formal documents. We have annual reports, we have financial statements, we have newsletters, blogs and things like that. We should also get information, or we can information from them. Talk with supervisors, colleagues and customers, definitely. And the last one is ask your audience for input, right? This is also very important in the form of feedback, or maybe if it is an interactive session, so you can ask your audience to give the input at the time of the process as well, right? Then going further, we have a few more things to discuss here. The first thing is to uncover the audience's needs. Definitely we are talking about the information needs here. Most of the times the audience is clear about what they need and they successfully communicate what they need, but in some cases, most of the time, the audience is not clear about their information needs. Maybe they are clear about the information need, but they have not been able to communicate properly that what are their information needs. So in that case, it is up to you, it is up to the writer, it is up to the person who is gathering information to try to read things between the lines and try to find relevant information. The next thing is finding your focus. Whenever we are writing, focus is very important. Focus actually defines our whole writing, whole message that we are actually creating. So when you are clear about the focus, you would always write in a very relevant and concise manner. But if you are not focused, your writing will not be concise, your writing will not be coherent, it will not be giving a good meaning, right? So in most of the cases, it often happens to us that we have such vague ideas and vague information that we are unable to write in a concise and concrete way, in a focused way. There is a popular technique for that. It is called free writing. In free writing, what we do, you just start writing without thinking anything. Without thinking, just we have an inner critic inside us, right? And that critic actually dictates that what is right, what is wrong. So we should turn off that inside critic for a while, and what we should do, we should just start writing without thinking anything. So when you do this type of exercise, most of the time you find your focus, that what are you actually more inclined towards, right? So finding your focus is very important before writing. And the last thing is providing the required information. Whenever you are providing the required information, definitely in any communication you are actually providing certain information, but before providing that information, we should be able to answer a few questions. The information that we are providing, that information should be complete. It should be able to answer a few questions: who, what, when, where, why, and how. These are the few things. It is also known as a journalistic approach to check whether your message is of a good quality. You should check whether your message answers to who, what, where, why, how, and when. Right? If your message is answering these questions, then you're good to go. Your message is complete. Just be sure that your message is accurate. The information which is being provided, it should be accurate. The quality of that information should be good, right? Because otherwise it can face it can cause maybe some safety problems, some legal issues, maybe some financial losses or things like that can happen. So information should be accurate. Information should be ethical. Now this is very important. We have already discussed the ethical issues regarding communication. So be sure that your information is ethical. And the last one is, be sure that your information is pertinent. Be sure that your information is relevant to the audience. Right? Be sure that your information is where it is supposed to be. Only then it will be of use. If you are sending information that is not relevant to the audience, and to put it another way, maybe you're sending information to the wrong audience, it would only cost you time and energy, and it won't result into anything good, right? So these were the first two steps of the planning process that we discussed today. We will continue it in our next lecture. That was it for today. I hope to have a good question answer sessions in our live class. Thank you so much. Have a good day.